This is experiment number 3. What is the aim of our experiment? To study the variation of the time period capital T of a simple pentagram with its length capital L and to plot L versus T square graph. Okay, now what are the apparatus required? We require a simple pentagram, stand, stop clock, meter scale. Okay, now this is simple pendulum. We can see that this is simple pendulum. This is only a flexible thread attached with a metallic box. And the stand, here is the stop clock. You can see that is stop clock and this is meter scale. Right? Now, plus, how can I calculate the time period? What do you mean by the time period for stop clock? Time period means time taken to complete one oscillation by the simple pendulum. One oscillation means, for example, I release the pendulum from the left extreme position. Okay? And when the pendulum come back to the same position after one oscillation, this is called, when the pendulum moves from left extreme position, goes up to the right extreme position, and come back to the left extreme position, this is called one oscillation. And how much time is taken by the pendulum to complete one oscillation is called its time period. Okay? Now, this is stop clock and you can see that the stop clock, this is stop clock and you can see that the least count of this stop clock is 1 second because there are 10 divisions between 0 to 10 seconds. There are 10 divisions. Okay? Now, first of all, we can find out how much time taken by this pendulum to complete an oscillation. N mainly 20, 10. So whatever the time taken by the pendulum is represented by T. So how can I calculate the time period by dividing T and N? Okay. Now let us perform the experiment. First of all, find out the length of this pendulum. I can say that the length of the pendulum can be measured from this point. This is the point of suspension and this is the center of the box. The distance between the point of suspension to the center of the box is found to be 50 cm. I have already noted down here the length is 50 cm. Let us calculate the time period. Okay? I will perform 20 oscillation. I will allow 20 oscillation. And how much time taken by the pendulum for the 20 oscillation, we can calculate by its invariance. Let us start performing the experiment. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, let us see how much time is taken by the pendulum for 20 oscillation. This is almost 27 seconds. Look at this, 27 seconds. Right? So, let us put the value here, 27 seconds divided by 20 seconds divided by 20. Okay, what will be the time period now? It is automatically 20 and okay, 7. 1.3 seconds will be the time. Now let us increase the length of the pendulum. Let us increase the length L to say 50 to 60 cm. Let us enhance the length by 10 cm. Okay? Let us change the length from 50 to say it is 1. The new length of this pendulum is increased from 50 cm to the 60 cm. This is 60 cm. Okay. Now again find out the time period. New length is 60 cm. What will be the time period? Then the new time period is represented by T2. This is T2 upon N. Then only will be the time taken for 20 oscillation and will be the number of oscillation. And let us find out. Let us perform again 20 oscillation. Right? Let us allow this pendulum to perform 20 oscillation and find out the time period. Start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, How much time is taken by the pendulum this time? It is 30 seconds. Time is found to be 30 seconds.
This is 30
divided by 20. Now time is enhanced by 1.5 seconds. You can clearly say it is 1.5 seconds.
Now, what is the square of the time period? Let us find out the square of the time period t bar square and the square of the time period t2 square. Right? 1.3 square means it is 1.69 second square. And nu is 2.25 second square. Right? Now let us try to plot the graph between time period versus length versus time period square. What is your expectations? The graph is supposed to be a straight line. Although we require more data, like T3, T4, T5, we require so many data to plot the graph. But plus, only for example, I am only taking two values, T1 and T, meaning two time periods, corresponding to the length L1 and L2, that is 50 cm and 60 cm respectively. How to plot the graph? Let us say length along the x-axis and time period square along the y-axis. Okay? Now, as I told that the length is taken as 10, 20, 30, or say starting with the initial is 40 cm, 50, 60, 70, all the values are in centimeter. The starting value is taken as 40 cm. Corresponding time period, let it be, this is 1, 2, 3, these are the values. Okay, the first value is 1.69. Corresponding to the 50, it is 1.69 between 1 and 2, somewhere here. Right? And the next value is 2.25 corresponding to 60. You can say lesser than here. So if you join the two points, you will see the shape of the graph like this. This is obviously a straight line. The shape of the graph is a straight line. It suggested that really the time period is directly proportional to, can I say, the time period of a simple pendulum is proportional to its length. Time period of a simple pendulum is proportional to its length by taking other data. By taking more and more data, we can verify it very clearly. And ultimately, we will see that the time period of a simple pendulum is given by 2pi under root L upon G. Right? 2pi under root L upon G. Here L is length of the pendulum, you can take this as a capital L or something. G acceleration due to gravity, D is time period, and 2pi is a constant of proportionality. Thank you so much.